There seems to be a lot of confusion about who the true God is. Well, let's see if we can break it down for you a bit. Now, biblically speaking, El Elyon is the highest God. You'll find the Bible, the last vestiges of polytheism when the land of Israel, or Canaan, believed in many gods. El Elyon is the one who gave this land to Yahweh as an inheritance back in Deuteronomy 32. But understand, we're only speaking biblically concerning the highest God. As within the Bible, moving on to the New Testament, the Father that Jesus spoke about was much different than the God Yahweh in the Old Testament. It's obvious the Father of Jesus is very dissimilar from Yahweh. Now, moving away from the Bible, let's talk about the historical roots of a God called El. El is the Semitic word for God, but the word is also used as a personal name. El was part of the ancient religion of the Canaanites as well as the land of Israel very early on. You see, the Israelites were originally Canaanites. Jews and Arabs are all descended from the Canaanites. The fact was proven after examining the DNA of 93 bodies recovered from the archaeological sites around the southern Levant. Researchers concluded that modern populations of the region are all descendants of the ancient Canaanites. Most modern Jewish groups, as well as the Arabic-speaking groups from the region, all show that at least half of their ancestry is Canaanite. Canaanite religion seems to have involved a rich mythological tradition that served as a bridge between the ancient Mesopotamian religions and the later Greek and Roman gods. Several of the most famous Greek gods, for example, clearly evolved from the Canaanite predecessors. This is just as several of the Canaanite gods grew out of Mesopotamian roots. After the supposed Hebrew invasion of Canaan and the genocidal orders from their god Yahweh, the Hebrews not only acquired the Canaanite lands, but they also took the name of the Canaanite high god and added it as a designation to their own tribal god. This was a common practice in ancient times of conquerors taking conquered god names and titles and adding them to their own gods. You know, our God's bigger than your God. It was just another way of proclaiming your God's power. In doing so, they added much of El's uniqueness as a wise and merciful father of many sons and added many of them to the personality of Yahweh. To his Canaanite worshippers, El was El, the compassionate one, El, the merciful one, El, the kindly one, as well as El, the father of humanity, and El, the creator of all created things. In Canaan, the promised land, El was considered compassionate and wise above all things. And in the ancient Syrian city of Ugarit, El was the highest god, and he had 70 sons. This El is totally unlike the Israelite god who is well known for his wrathful judgments. And as we said, there seems to be a lot of confusion about who God is. And biblically speaking, El Elyon is the highest God. But bring the two groups together again. Sounds like Yahweh was possibly one of the 70 sons of the god El. In fact, the Bible's tables of nations being 70 nations corresponds to this idea. However, remember, Israel wasn't even a nation at the time. So we can't say for sure that Yahweh was even one of the 70. However, biblically speaking, he did receive Israel after creating a new land for himself. Now, back to the highest God. We're convinced that all of the biblical concepts are primitive man's concepts of a higher power, but not the true creator of all. No, we think there is a God, a higher power, a supreme source. But those Canaanite and Israelite concepts are just that. They're concepts. And as far as we're concerned, the Native Americans who called on the Great Spirit for guidance were closer to being correct than the concepts found in the Hebrew Tana in the Old Testament. It's possible the Great Spirit used the Hebrews and their jealous tribal god to overturn a Canaanite polytheism so that humanity would understand that there is only one creator of all. The Great Spirit recognized the Canaanite El, because El truly did reflect the best of the masculine or fatherly aspects of the source. And that's why the Great Spirit kept El's spirit alive all through the Old Testament. It just takes an eye to see and an ear to hear. Jesus' famous teachings of compassion, forgiveness of sins, and non-judgment from a wisdom stance all come directly from the way El was seen in the Canaanite religion. After all, Jesus was from the northern kingdom of Israel, who had originally worshipped El as the father of the gods. We think Jesus taught the concepts of the higher God. If you investigate closely, you'll see who the good father Jesus was teaching about. And it was certainly not the national God of Israel. But it is our opinion there is a higher God than all the national tribal gods. I'm calling that supreme deity, for simplicity's sake, the Great Spirit. It is a universal spirit, an eternal truth, and infinite reality. Now, thinking Jesus is the son of El Elyon is way better than thinking he came from Yahweh, a lesser god, but I don't think that that's all he intended us to think. Jesus knew the higher concept of power and creation, and said we could too. In closing, we may be considered atheists if Yahweh is our only option for the higher power, the Great Spirit.